Hi, Farah here from Attuned. Today, I will talk about how to avoid demotivating your top performers. Hire good people and get out of their way. That's what you're supposed to do, right? Or that's what the Steve Jobs tropes tell us. But hiring isn't that simple, nor is the motivation part. Yes, employees need a certain level of autonomy and the freedom to learn and grow. But people's motivations come in all shapes and sizes, and many will require more from you as a manager than just removing obstacles from their path. Number one, motivate people from top to bottom. You've already got top performers on your team. Now, how do you keep the top performance happening? You need to give them what they need. Let them perform. Don't look over their shoulders. That should be the easy part. But how do you give them what they really need? You can start off easily enough. If someone has the same motivational needs as you, for example, competition, it's easy enough to know how to keep them happy. Maybe you don't share motivational needs, but the person is clear enough in their communication that you can tell what makes them tick. However, there are other things to look out for that may not be indicated directly or easily. Things such as understanding your employee's work history, promotion record, and personal circumstance all come together in order to help you maintain high achievers and keep their motivations up. Number two, embrace negative feedback. Even if you're leading a team of top achievers, they're not always going to be happy. This may or may not reflect on your role as a manager, but learning how to embrace negative feedback is an essential skill. It may be uncomfortable, but if someone has decided that they want to speak to you about their problems, it's actually a blessing in disguise. Since you've already heard all of their concerns and issues, you are able to move forward with clarity and do things that can improve the situation without all of the tricky guesswork that usually comes along with managing a team. Number three, give yourself space to be wrong. To manage a diverse, talented team that performs well, you will need to interact with a diverse set of intrinsic motivational needs. To manage in such a personalized way, you'll need to help. That's why we built Attuned. But you'll also sometimes be wrong. The key is to give yourself space to be wrong. Let your team know you will try to craft an environment that is best for their personal situation, but that you are still going to get things wrong. There are just too many variables. Let them know that if things aren't great, that they can communicate that. And when they do, listen, try to understand and accept. As a top performer, they are putting a lot of their energy, passion, and identity into that performance. When things aren't going well, it can become emotional. You might be met, perhaps unexpectedly, with a wave of their intense feelings. If so, let that wave of feeling wash over you and try to empathize with them. But the most important thing is to not push back, which is probably your instinctual response, like getting caught up in a real wave or a reverse undercurrent. Let yourself go slack. Let the currents do their thing. You'll pop up for air soon enough and be able to handle the situation. On a wider scale, think carefully about the system you're creating, the environment your norms are built, and whether or not this gives you and your team the space to get things wrong sometimes. If you do this successfully, you'll create a sense of belonging, security, and ultimately, psychological safety. This is Farah, and thanks for watching. Bye.